friends, today I'm going to talk to you about lips, which is a very interesting topic. So what are beautiful lips? A beautiful lip should have good volume in its body. It should have a well-defined cupid's bow, a well-defined vermilion border, a well-defined philtral column, and the angle of the lip should be in the right place. If the angle is droopy, it gives a very sad appearance to the face. Also, the middle tubercle, which is in the upper lip, should sit correctly in between the two lateral tubercles in the lower lip. And also, the proportion between the upper and the lower lip is important. The upper lip is usually 1/3 compared to the 2/3 lower lip, and this balance gives it the beautiful appearance. Also, the divine ratio or the golden proportion, which I was talking to you about, the phi ratio, which is 1:1.618. So if the upper lip is 1, the lower lip should be 1.618 to give it that balanced and harmonious appearance. Also, when we see the profile picture of the patient, when we draw a line from the tip of the nose to the chin, the lower lip is projected much more compared to the upper lip. The upper lip is usually 4 mm behind this line and the lower lip is 2 mm behind this line. As the lips are on the teeth, the occlusion of the teeth is also very important for us to know the projection of the lips. So if the upper lip is projected anteriorly, it could be because of an overbite in the teeth. And if it is less projected, it could be because of an underbite, and the dental alignment has to be corrected if you want the right proportion. Now, when this balance or harmony, that is when I said 1/3, 2/3 proportion is lost, that is when there is the upper lip is almost same size as the lower lip, it gives an undesirable appearance. Or if the upper lip is projected too much anteriorly, or sometimes the lip can be too long in width, and the outer side of the lip has less volume compared to the middle half of the lip. Sometimes the outer side of the lip can be turned inwards, giving it the eagle wing appearance. Now, all these are some of the small defects that we can easily correct with fillers. A filler which is the right product, which is chosen by the right specialist, is important for lip enhancement. We use fillers that are easily moldable, because the lips are highly used in animation while speaking, talking, and therefore a stiff filler can cause distortions while speaking, and therefore we need something that will mold very comfortably inside the lips. So we have special products available for the lip enhancement. And these small disproportions, when we correct, it gives a very beautiful appearance to the lips. Also, with aging, we lose volume. The upper lip becomes longer and the lower lip, the chin becomes closer to the lower lip, and that changes the proportion on the face. Also, the angle starts drooping and there is appearance of perioral lines. And all these can be corrected by using dermal fillers. Thank you very much for your kind attention, and I'll be back next week with another small tip on beauty. Thank you and bye-bye.